Yo guys, what is going on? Timper here. Welcome back to another video on the channel.
Going to the jeweler, bust the AP, yeah. Sliding on the water like a jet ski, yeah. I'm trying to fuck you on your bestie, yeah.
In today's video, as you can tell by the title, it's how to make a Fortnite styled YouTube banner, and I'll also be giving away a free template, so yeah. Make sure you hit the like button for that, and also let me know down below in the comments what video you'd like to see from me next, or what template you want, anything. You guys know that I read them and I will reply to as many as possible. So yeah, how to make a Fortnite styled YouTube banner today. I hope you guys really enjoy this video, and yeah, let's get right into it. Right guys, so we're here in Photoshop. I'm just looking outside and it's absolutely snowing it down here in England. But anyway, back to the video. So yeah, making the Fortnite banner, and the pack I'm going to be using is actual Visual Arts Fortnite graphics pack. You guys can go download that. I'll put a link in the description to the pack and also his channel. But yeah, this is the pack. It's got pretty much everything you need, as it says. All you need Fortnite graphics pack. But yeah, just got I've got a YouTube banner template open, and the first thing I'm going to do is get a wallpaper, and there's really nice wallpapers there that you can just choose from the Battle Royale, but also the Save the World, you know, there. But I'm just going to find one. I might just go for that, to be honest. Pretty simplistic, and then we're going to add some CCs and all that. It's decent quality, so just going to make it bigger. In fact, what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to actually get like multiple images and combine them together. So you want to get a few different images. I've got that one. I'm going to get that one right there. Put that in there. Maybe this one. Nah, not that one. That one looks good. That's from the 50 versus 50. Fortnite, but yeah, bring that in, and I'm just going to combine them all together, make sure that I can actually see that one right there, and yeah, looking nice. So we're just going to get the eraser tool, make sure it's on zero hardness, and we're just going to rub away the sides, make sure it looks good, like so. Maybe a bit more. And then do the same on the other side as well. Like so. Looking nice. So now we've got that, we're gonna add some nice CCs to it. So there's actually some in the Fortnite graphics pack, but you can make your own. So I'm just gonna have a look at the different ones. So you've got that. Ooh. Got that. Got that. So let's just give this one a go. Ooh. Give this one a go right here. And hide. It looks good. It's made everything pop out a bit more, but it's... yeah, it's okay. I might see what the other one looks like. I quite liked this one right here, so I'm going to drag that one in. I think I prefer that, to be honest. Oh, do you? Yeah, I do. I prefer that. So I like that, but I'm going to add some of my own just to make it fit a lot better. So I'm going to add brightness and contrast. Bring up brightness, bring up the contrast. Curves. Make a little S shape like so, and then exposure, bring up the exposure, offset, bring that up, and the gamma correction, and then you can choose whichever color you want, but I'm going to go to color balance and make it more orangey, more like that, and then I'm just going to group all that together like so. The next thing I'm going to do is add a white spot at the top. So, and now I'm going to go to rectangle tool, and then on the sides make a small strip like so, and change that to overlay. Now you can either have that white, or if you press Ctrl U, make it black. It'll look good like that as well, like a black overlay. It gives it a nice effect. I might do that actually, I'm not too sure. See what it looks like. It looks quite good. But yeah, next I'm going to add around the outsides just a small dark shadow. So yeah, like that. And then I'm going to group all the things I've just done. So the white highlight, the shadows around the outside, and then lines going across top and bottom, and bring it below the CCs that we've added. And that looks a lot better. So I've got a really, really nice layout background going on right there. And what you can also do is maybe add like spots of color. So maybe like down here, add an orange. Maybe up there as well, and change that to color dodge. It just makes things pop out a bit more. Maybe add one at the bottom down there. And maybe one at the top. And then bring that below all them CCs again to make it pop, but maybe bring down the opacity. And then the next thing we're going to do is actually add some text. So the font I'm going to be using is called Evogria. You can get it on dafont.com. I'm just going to put Timpers in the center, and I'm going to make it white for now. Make it bigger, make sure it's Evogria. That's, yeah, it's called Evogria. And it looks really nice. And then next thing I'm going to do is press Ctrl T, hold Shift and Control, and then just move it to the right a bit. Gives it a slant, looks nice. And I'm going to put it right in the center. Then I'm going to double click on the layer and go to Gradient Overlay. And add like a little overlay. Change it to add an inner glow as well. Sorry, and change down the opacity. Make sure it's on overlay. And yes, so that's looking good. However, I might try this with a rectangle tool, just go to black. I just add like a rectangle around it. Obviously, I'll make it fit. That kind of works. Something like that, maybe. Maybe if you do something like that. That looks quite good. Maybe if I just make it even on both sides. That looks quite good. Next thing I'm going to do is just go to the rectangle, add a gradient, and bring down the opacity of that. And then I'm going to add a spot of white in the center. And bring down, make sure that's on overlay. Bring down the opacity a little bit. I don't think the rectangle is directly in the center. I'm just going to move that. That should be fine, actually. And then I'm going to put above that official channel of. Make that smaller. I'm going to make that the dark black kind of color. Then I'm going to put that above. And I'm going to increase the spacing on that. So yeah, it's looking really nice. And then on the left and right hand side, you can put social media. So yeah, I might just do that right now. So, social media icons. Get the Twitter one on there. And then I'm just gonna add like, I'm just gonna add a little effect just to make it stand out a bit more. Add a drop shadow. Nice, and then I'm going to copy that layer style, and then once I've added these, maybe Snapchat, I'm going to paste on that layer style that I've just created. So yeah, that is about it for the tutorial. It's a really nice Fortnite style YouTube banner. If you guys want more like this, like thumbnails, let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know what other videos you'd like to see. Like the video, that would really mean a lot for this awesome template and tutorial. Subscribe if you are new, and I'll see you guys in the next video.